It's Deesus here, and we're playing a little bit more Hearthstone, so I managed to finally hit Diamond, ranked Diamond. So we are now on our way to Legend. I'm having a really good win rate with this Rogue deck. I'm running a King's Bane deck, which has always been one of my favorite deck archetypes. It hasn't been as popular, but I feel like there's been some recent cards that actually made it really strong. So we'll kind of go over the deck after this game, but I've been pretty pleased overall with how it's performed. It's a druid here. Hopefully we can draw into some more of our damage. Draw into a card that can recover King's Bane. No. Well, can't take the chance of not having King's Bane. We have lots of draw power, so I'm not too worried about it. But he's going to end up getting. Oh, excellent. So he's going to actually help us draw. We shouldn't need too much help with that. So if his goal is to fatigue, I believe we will deal fatal before he fatigues. Excellent. That's what we want. King's Bane.
Lapdogs, all of you! Job
done. So out of the new cards we have at our disposal, it makes the King's Bane Rogue what I think is potentially I wouldn't say S tier, but A tier deck. You know, this is one of them. Battle cry, swap your hand with the bottom of your deck. So this is just another tool we have at our disposal to potentially get the cards we need. Which is just pretty awesome. Let's keep drawing.
Lapdogs, all of you!
And the reason I kind of did that is even though we're about to get hit, you should be able to recover most of that between leeching poison and doomering. And we still have 3 card spots. And if he doesn't kill both my guys, then I can actually do more to face potentially. Because that would be 4, 5, 6. Or I could do 4 or 5. Let's see, 4 more would do. Oh, it's only a 3. I think that Trickster's Sharp Sword Oral, didn't that used to be 4? Like, it used to be 4 back in the day. Okay, so I think what we are actually going to do. Do this. This.
Feed the fish, land lover.
This. And we'll draw 2 cards. Draw 2 more cards. Okay.
Simply lack perspective. My time is almost up.
Lapdogs, all of you.
You'll be
point, it really just depends how much heal he's got. So we will wipe him. Still good. Also getting bonus stars? I didn't realize you continue to get bonus stars. Do you get bonus stars until Diamond 5 now? Alright, well, I'll go ahead and kind of explain the deck for those interested. So, we're actually going to have Shadow of Demise, so this is one of our newest cards that we get to add to the deck, and I mean, there's just a lot of really good cards we can target, so if we want more damage to our weapon, we can do, like, Deadly Poison. If we want, you know, more Doomerings, like, this would be excellent. I mean, if you end up popping, like, a Lifesteal, and then you use, you know, this is an extra Doomering, you know, you could full heal and wipe out three taunts if you wanted to, or, you know, whatever you might want to do. If you ended up needing more draw power, if you needed a little bit more oomph to finish the fight, there's just a lot of good things that could grab. Obviously, we have our Buccaneer for more damage. This is the only pirates in our deck, and we're only running one raiding party. So, you know, I think the standard Bane deck is running a couple additional pirates and then running two of these, but I would honestly rather have the Ghostly Strike or the Dredge combo draw card, so that I can have, you know, more control over what I get. Plus, we're going to be able to use Sir Finley here to dig at the bottom of our deck. So this really just creates just a powerhouse combo that has actually worked very efficiently. I'll kind of show you. I've only done like 5 games. I've only lost one, so I can show you real fast on my deck tracker here. So we are at an 83% win rate. And honestly, I could argue this would have been 100%. The shaman I was going up against, it was a totem shaman, and he just had a ludicrous hand. He got his 8/8 drops, he had 2 taunts, and he had, I forget the name of the weapon, but it's the weapon that duplicates all your totems. And then he also had his 5/5 drop that discounts based on totems you've played. So he just had a powerhouse hand. It was a brutal matchup. So we're going against a Warlock.
None may challenge the brother.
That's a really leaf poison. The fact that it just stays on your weapon is really nice. This creates a lot of draw power. I mean, it can end up fatiguing you at the end, like we just saw, where I took 5 extra damage. But I would say the draw power is worth it, and typically, we should be killing them beforehand. So the Renthal Warlock, I haven't fought that in a while. So I'm actually going to coin here, Dredge, draw. Having a deck counter is amazing. So if you guys do not run a deck tracker. You can actually get one at NetDeck. It's through Replay, so it's pretty good. Okay, we're going to go ahead and just get our basic weapons. Our basic dagger, or not cool dagger. So I feel like he's trying to potentially draw into something. So we're going to use Sir Finley now, hopefully find one of our cards that's going to get us King's Bane. Where there are so many. Should draw King's Bane anytime. Come on, King's Bane, you can do it. You can do it, little buddy. There we go. I'm gonna actually do this. Still King's Bane from us. It's not happened yet. I believe I would be quite upset. The only one I can really think of that can consistently do it would be that 6 drop that you get to trade a card out for one of the cards in your opponent's hand. That really doesn't affect this deck. You may have my pirate. I'll use that life steal next turn. I mean, might as well. It's going to burn up anyway. Maybe we'll get lucky and draw a cutting class and draw into our Tinker's Sharpwood Oils or something. It's honestly stupid. Should I go ahead and... Yeah, I probably should, shouldn't I? Why not? Save 4 more to the face. I mean, I have another heal. Oh, there's a guy smoking up that Duke. There's really nothing he's going to take from me that's going to be all that phenomenal for him. I can see him taking Secret Passage. So that was, I think, a very favorable matchup because our opponent was already doing a lot of damage to himself. Time I've had some luck in Hearthstone. I'll tell you what, it's been a pretty rough season. Everybody had a good holiday. Yeah, I was actually theory crafting earlier today. Me and my son was playing Pokemon, and we were playing some because he ended up getting new Pokemon game, so we were playing Pokemon Scarlet, and then we played the trading card game, and we played some Wrecker earlier today, and I keep having a lot of issues with recording my Oculus, so I really don't know what's going on with that. It's been kind of frustrating. Like, my Oculus will just randomly decide to stop recording. And I try to have like my webcam set up while I'm running
all
Oculus.
All I want this Winterfell is restitution for the Brotherhood.
I absolutely love this skin. But anyway, my theorycraft that I had, sorry, I'm all over the place. Theorycraft that I had, using Plague Spreader with Infectious Ghoul with Priest, and then using the card that discounts your Death Rattles by 3, but then they die the same turn that they're played. So I've had some fun with that, but I think Plague Spreader is actually glitched out right now. If you guys would like to try on your end to see if I'm right, I think what it does is, so the card's effect is it replaces a minion card in the hand of your opponent with Plague Spreader. So the idea is every one of your opponent's cards is now Plague Spreader, which is probably worthless. However, that's not what happens. Like, and I feel like Plague Spreader can evidently target Plague Spreader. So if you have nothing but Plague Spreaders in your hand, there's a chance it can pick a card that's already a Plague Spreader, because Plague Spreader is a minion. And so I think what's happening is Plague Spreader ends up targeting the other Plague Spreaders in hand, and so it's not as strong as I thought it would be, because I thought I could get their entire hand to be just that, and so obviously that disrupts combos. Okay, let's see what we got here. So we want Lifesteal for sure. For his money, for certain. Was very fortunate. Okay, let's see what we got here.
Pirates away! Feed the fish, landlubber.
Black dogs, all of you!
We'll for sure draw it next turn, so. 7, or we're going to have a chance here. It's a very strong matchup. He definitely could do pretty good. He could possibly have the same Tinker. Is he gonna tinker? If he tinker, well, he can't tinker. But you do them small, right? So I'm showing 8. So 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, yep. So when this card comes in the clutch, and then I'll take one round of fatigue, two rounds of fatigue, so this actually is going to kill me too. That means it's a draw? Or does it count as my loss? I mean, I'm happy with the tie on that. He'd like to be my friend. He's like, he's like, I don't know what just happened. We just, like, sword fought each other to the brutal death. Now let's be friends. Oh, I feel like I got pretty lucky on that one. I'm not even sad about tying. That guy's start was strong. That's a strong deck. There's no denying that. Of course, I am trying to make the argument that King's Bane Rogue is S tier, so we'll see if I can do that by the end of this video. You guys tell me if you think it's S tier. I don't know. Some bad stuff up there. Ah, here we go. We can redeem ourselves against even Shaman. I feel it's definitely a very competitive deck. So we are going to coin. Down there, maybe he'll trade into it if he buffs his shaman or he buffs his totem. He did not, so he's very slow start for us. At least he doesn't seem to have all of his combo pieces either. Pretty good. We are at least going to not even reason to attack it. He would just heal. can just live long enough here, I might be in business. We really need life still.
Lapdogs, all of you.
That deck's insane. I think that this deck would have had a chance against him. I would have had to have had a much better start. I would have had to have had my life still, probably for sure. Blade Flurry. Like, I think if I Blade Flurried him, once he had a full board like that, I think we would have been to the point then where we would have been able to keep up. Diamond 5 this season. I would expect a new legend this season, but
none may challenge the
brotherhood. I'm gonna keep trying for that. Secret Passage, I like to hold on to. So if nothing else, I can mulligan. Terrible start. That's an awful start. Hopefully he's going to be a druid that wants me to have lots of draw. Like, maybe he's going to help me draw some cards.
The sea nope. Lord, he is all
he's going to be the annoying one.
I see a vision in the flames.
This is probably token. Probably worth it to dredge here. Oh. Right through one of them. So. Counter. I'm assuming he'll counter a spell.
Predictable.
let them harm the eggs.
Drone power.
Could go ahead and kill him. I would love to have all this draw power I'm supposed to have. That's at least something. We still have one. Oh, wow. That's annoying. Blade Flurry and wipe him, which I'll need to. So I already know exactly what he's landing on doing. Well, he's won this deal. That card's gonna deal 16 damage.
Exactly enough.
definitely sounds pretty fun to play. I prefer duels. I just like how ridiculous duels can get.
Edwin versus Edwin.
The Scourge will meet
the
end.
I had, none may challenge the Brotherhood. A few days ago was really nuts. Okay, yeah, that's a decent, setup. I'm assuming we are going to go against another pirate rogue. So we race to face here. Surprising. Go ahead and, well, I kind of think doubling up on draw power is what we'll probably need to do with our bonus spell. We are going to need it. And that's kind of one of our advantages, I feel. Just being able to draw all of our cards pretty quick. Still faster.
What he's got here.
He does not have as good of a round going as the first guy we fought. First guy we fought, Phil, was drawing cards better. Was having better luck. Okay. As long as he doesn't kill us this turn, we should be okay. But he'll summon at least something. Oof. For face, if you will, okay.
Never bring a sword to a fish fight.
Okay. still. Which we're going to do quite a bit to face if he doesn't set up anything. We already know he's going to draw his swordfish. He'll tell you four. He'll hit for four. Okay, we will do lifesteal. He can do fatal, and I was not gonna go a whole nother turn without doing some damage, or we'll never end the game. That guy probably would have went four. So we will just do this right here. I'm gonna draw.
No shiny.
I'm blowing myself away after they're friendly. Can you do like a one turn kill with that using Druid, because you could possibly do, that would be two extra cards. Does it count the original card? So I'm just thinking, Outcry. You could definitely potentially kill somebody.
You serve me in death. None may challenge the Brotherhood.
I love that card, but not my opening hand, I don't think. Most of the time, Death Knight plays three Blood Runes and is more of a control deck, a little bit slow. Unless this is an Unholy One. Oh, nope, he's Frost.
Reach for the skies.
He's going to be a little bit more aggressive. We at least have cutting class for draw power, so there's that. You're gonna end up getting hit a few times. Always stinks when they have some pretty decent early game. Because they don't have much of an early game. Okay, we are gonna hope for the best here. Finley, okay. Well, there's King's Bane. So I wonder if this will effectively draw these two extra cards. We'll go back to my main hand. I'm assuming it works that way. It does. That's actually very strong. And thankfully we have a lot of our cards we want here. He's going to ignore me. We could draw a bunch of cards. Dang it. Yeah, this is gonna be a bad matchup, isn't it? Surely he won't be lethal. Being frozen with this deck is awful. Again? Dear Lord. Absolute madness. I have no way to heal up now. Does he have a way to freeze me again?
Fish, land lover.
Let's see what we're sitting at now, win rate wise. 64% win rate. I call BS though on some of those. I'm trying to think if I want to keep playing, if I'll call it good tonight. I think I'm going to probably call that good on this one. So, YouTube, I appreciate you watching. If there's any improvements you can see me making on the deck, let me know. I would still highly recommend playing it, even though those last handful of games were garbage. I feel like all in all, it's a pretty good deck. I think it's at least an A-tier deck. It just has some really bad matchups there. It can be countered. It's the only bad thing about kind of having that one gimmick, so... Alright YouTube, it was good gaming with you, and I will probably start doing a duels run tonight, so I will see you for that.